Hello friends and welcome back on my channel. My name is Alex and for this weekend I have another interesting project which I was working on, and this is a plug with animal traction. So this is it, and this project will have two videos. In first video I'm gonna make the moldboard, the wheel support and the axis, the central axis. And in the next video I'm gonna make the rest of the parts and I'm gonna assemble them. So if you want to see how to make this plow, please follow and don't forget to share it if you like it. Let's begin. We start with the wheel. We'll have to open another part in SolidWorks, and here we'll have to open a sketch in the front plane, and here we'll have to make the next sketch. First we'll have to make one big circle and another one smaller, and then two which will be smaller than first. Now we'll have to dimension this. This will have 200 millimeters in diameter from this one to this one. Will be 17.25 millimeters. This one will have the diameter of 17.5 multiplied by 2, okay, and this one will have the diameter of 17 millimeters. Now we'll have to make a center line starting from this center point, and now with line we'll have to make here a line, make it vertical, and now with mirror we'll mirror this line, mirror about, we'll use this center line. Okay, now we'll have to dimension this from this line to this line. Here will be 5 millimeters. Now this is perfect. We'll use circular sketch pattern to multiply these two lines. Here we'll put 4, I'm sorry. Here we'll keep 360 degrees. And now press OK. Now select this point and this circle. Select here, make coincident, and do the same with this one. Good. Now we'll use trim entities command to cut some parts of these circles. So first we'll cut this and then this. Good. Now go to features, use extruded boss base command, and here we'll put 38 millimeters, and you can select here mid plane, press OK, and the wheel is done. Now we'll get to the next part, which will be the wheel support, and for this we'll open first, we'll have to save this. So I'll write here wheel, okay, and I'm gonna save it on my desktop. Now I'm gonna put here wheel 1, okay, and now open another part. And here we'll have to open a sketch in the front plane, and we'll have to make the wheel support. We're gonna make a rectangle first. Now we'll have to dimension this. First select this line and this point, and select here make midpoint. And now let's dimension this. this line here will have 40 millimeters. Okay, now this one will have 400. Okay, now select circle and let's make 9 circles. One here and then one here. Okay, now let's dimension these two first. Select this one and we'll have the diameter of 17 millimeters. Select this point and this one and this one and select here, make it horizontal. Make these two equal. Okay, now the distance between this center point and this center point is 140 millimeters. And the distance from this edge, this line, to this center point is 20 millimeters. Good. Now, to make it easier, to make the other 7 circles, we're gonna use linear sketch pattern. We'll select this circle. And here we'll put 8. And then a dimension, we'll put 30 millimeters. Good. Now press OK. And to fully define this with smart dimension, we'll give here the dimension of 30 millimeters. Press OK. And this is done. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Perfect. Now go to features, use extruded boss base. And here we'll put 20 millimeters. And press OK. Now the wheel support is done. We'll have to save this one also. And we'll just go here. And here I will write wheel support. And also on my desktop. Save. Now we'll have to make the next part, which will be the mold board. So in order to do this, we'll have to open another part. First we'll have to open a sketch in the top plane. And here we'll have to make the next sketch. Now let's define this part first. From this point to this point, here will be 28. Now from this point to this point, but on this other side, here will be 14. From this point line will be 126. And from this line to this line will be 240 millimeters. So now we'll have to do two center lines. One starting from that point and one starting from this point. Make them vertical. Now let's dimension them. From this one to this line, here will be 371.6. And from this one to this center line, to this line, here will be 417.5. Now select this point in this line, select here make midpoint. Now we have to make another center line, which will start from the middle of this line to this point, and from this line, this one, the angle will be 26 degrees. Now delete this, this one, and now we'll have to make the next part. So select line again, and we start from this line down, just like this. Now let's dimension this. Here will be 303 millimeters. Here will have 90. The angle here will be 43 degrees. And from this center line to this line, okay, now from this center line to this line will be 80 millimeters. Now with trim entities command we'll cut this line here, and then select this point and this line. Select here, make midpoint. This. Okay, so now select this line. Select here, make collinear. This sketch is done. Now exit sketch. And select. Let me see. Select front plane, open a sketch, normal tool, and now we'll have to make just a simple line, but this line must be bigger than the first sketch. Now let's give some dimensions. From this point to this line will be 250 millimeters, and this line we have 1000. Now make a center line starting from this point till the middle of this line, and then make it vertical. Nice. Now exit sketch, open a sketch in the right plane. And here we have to make a 3 points arc. Just like this. And now let's dimension this. Here will be 300. Select these 2 points. Select here, make horizontal. Now select point and make a point in the middle of this arc, and make another one somewhere here on the arc. Now let's mention this. From this point to this point will be 68 millimeters. Now select this point in this line and select here make pierce. Okay, now let's see. We have to make sure that this arc is bigger than this sketch. Good, now it's perfect. Now exit sketch. Now we'll use some tools from surfaces. to make this part. So first we'll use boundary surface and we'll select this arc and then this line and press OK. And now we'll use trim surface and here we'll select this sketch and then we'll select this face. So if you have here remove selection and you select this, this side will be removed, the outside face. And if you have here keep selections, this what you select will be kept and will be removed the inner side. So we'll select here remove selection and we'll select this outer side. And here you must have standard. So press OK. And now we have our first part on this plow. So now we have to use another command from surface, which is thicken. And here we'll put 8 millimeters and we'll select this face. Press OK. This is looking good. Now what we'll have to do is open a sketch on this face. Open a sketch in normal tool. And here we'll have to make a line just like this. And then here it doesn't matter. And we'll go to features, use extruded cut. Here select tool and press OK. And now we'll have to open another sketch. And this one will be in the front pane. And here we'll have to make the next sketch. We'll make a rectangle like this. Now select these two lines. Select here, make parallel. Make these two equal. Nice. Now let's dimension this. Here will be 20 millimeters. This line will have 340 millimeters. And now let's select. Actually, no. What we'll have to do is select point command and make a point in the middle of this line. Select this point and this point and select here make good. And now let's give a dimension from this line to this point, and here will be 280 millimeters. Okay. I guess if I give here this dimension, yeah, sorry, this will fully define it. Okay, now go to features, use extruded boss base, and here we'll put 80 millimeters, and now press OK. Good. Okay, now open a sketch on this face. Normal tool, and here we'll have to make another rectangle. And this will have the dimension. Here we'll have 30 millimeters. And this line here will have 70. And now the dimension from this line, this edge, will be 250 millimeters. Now we'll go to features, use extruded boss base. Okay. And here we'll put 350 millimeters. And that direction 2, we'll put 40 millimeters. Press OK. And now we'll open sketch on this face. Now 2. And here we make here a small angle. Here we'll have the dimension of 40 millimeters. Yes, and now we'll make a rectangle here, starting from this edge, just like this. Now select this line and just select these two and select here, make parallel. Now drag this line and try to fix it be on this face, not to pass through this. Will be okay. Okay, we'll see if we'll have to edit this. We'll come back. Now go to features, use extruded boss base. Here select reverse direction and here put 30 millimeters. This is not bad, as you can see, is passing through this, but we'll cut this later. Or we can make it over 20 and it is still passing, but sorry. Make it 30 again and we'll cut this. Okay, now press OK and this is almost done. Select this face, open a sketch, small 2, and here we have to make the next sketch. First to make the line, this, triangle actually, and we'll give here a dimension, 170 is good. And here 25. Now go to features and use extruded cut. And here select up to and select this face. Now with fillet we'll make this edge round. So select fillet, select this edge and here put 150 millimeters and press OK. Now it's better. Now we'll have to open a sketch on this face. And here we'll have to make three circles. Here and one here. Now we'll have to dimension them. First, select all of them and make them equal. Then select the center points and select here, make vertical. And then select this point, and select here, make vertical. And now we'll have to dimension them. For this one, we have 14 millimeters in diameter. And then from this point to this edge, here will be 70 millimeters. Okay, now drag this one above, and from this center point will be 30 millimeters, and from this one will be 205. Now what we'll have to do is to go to features, use extruded cut, and here select up to surface, and then come on this side and select surface and press OK. Now we have to modify this to sketches, so we'll go here at both extruded. We'll click on this sketch, we'll go here, edit sketch, and then here we'll put 30 millimeters. Okay. And this one we'll move it up and we'll give here a dimension from this point to this edge will be 95 millimeters. Now exit sketch. Here we'll put 100 minutes. Go back and here put 100. Sketch. Okay, now we'll have to cut this corner. So in order to do this, we have to open a sketch. In this plane, the right plane. So open a sketch. Normal two. Here we'll have to make a 3-point arc. From this point to this point, this, and we have here the dimension of 299. Now with line we'll have to close this sketch so we can use features that cut, and here we'll select to all both and press OK. And now as you can see that corner is done, and this is working. So this part is done, and I'll save it on my desktop. Save as, and here I will select desktop and I'll put the name Plow. Yes. Okay, now this part is done and we'll have to start the next one, and in order to do this we'll have to select here new, and from here we'll select part and OK. And the last part from this video is the central axis. And for this we have to open a sketch in the top plane. And here we'll have to make the next sketch. First we'll have to make a rectangle. Just like this. Then we'll have to dimension this. Here will be 1245. Okay. Now the here will be 60 millimeters. This line. Select this point and this line. Select here make midpoint, and this is fully defined. Okay, now go to features. Actually, first let's make a small hole here with the diameter 14 millimeters. And from this center point to this will be 525. Good. Now select this point and this one and select here make horizontal. Now we'll go to features, use extruded boss base, select here mid plane, and here we'll put 20 millimeters. Press OK. Now we'll have to open a sketch in the top plane. And we'll have to make here the next sketch. We'll start with line, just like this. Okay, now we'll have to make a center line. Make it horizontal. Perfect, now select these two, make them equal. Do the same with these two. Now it's smart dimension, we'll give here the dimension of 120 millimeters. And from this line to this line will be 150. Now select this point and this line, select here make coincident. Okay. Now it's smart dimension, we'll give here the dimension of 80 millimeters. Okay, and now we'll have to make 4 circles here. So we'll select circle, we'll make one here and one here. Now let's define these two first. This one will have the diameter of 14 millimeters, and from this center point to this line will be 50 millimeters. Okay, and now we'll have to make a circle starting from this center point, make it till this center point, and then right click on it and select here construction geometry. And now select this circle and this one, select here make equal. Okay, now this circle will have the diameter of 160 millimeters. Good. Now we'll have to make 2 more circles on this circle. And 2 center lines starting from the center of those, just like this. Now let's define this. From this center line to this one will be 60 degrees, and from this one to this one will be 30 degrees. And now we'll have to select these two and this one and select here make equal. Good, now this sketch is done. Go to features, use extruded boss base command, and here put 10 mm, and here at blind select mid plane and press OK. This is looking good till now. Now select this face, open a sketch, normal tool, and here we have to make the next sketch. Okay, we'll select line and we'll make a line. We'll make a small sketch just like this. Actually delete this line and make another line, another one from this point to this point. Okay, now let's define this. So for first select these two, select here make equal, do the same with these two and this, just to be sure. Okay, and with trim entities, cut this. Okay. And now select this one and this one. Select here, make equal. Perfect. Now let's dimension this. From this line to this line will be 2 mm. And all of this will be 2. Okay. Perfect. Now this line here will have 46 mm, and from this line to this one will be 22. This one here will have 13 mm. This is good. And now from this line to this edge will be 177 mm. Perfect. Now this is fully defined. Go to features, use extruded boss base command, and here select up to surface, and we select this face. Okay. Nice. Now we'll have to do here one more thing. So select this face, open a sketch, normal tool. Okay. And now we'll have to make, we'll start with line and we'll make the next sketch. Okay, now we'll have to make a center line to mirror this on the other side. So select mirror, select these three lines, select a mirror about this line and press OK. Now with line we'll close this here too, and now we'll have to dimension this. This line will have 90 mm. Make these two equal. Okay. Now from this line to this edge will be 20 mm. From this point to this line will be 25. Okay, and now from this line to this edge will be 180 mm. Actually, here is not 20, so right click on that and delete it. From this line to this line will be 70 mm. Okay, And now we'll use offset entities command, and we'll select this sketch and we'll create an offset. Select here reverse direction, put here 20 and select it. Okay, so as you can see are 20 millimeters between this. Nice. Now let's see, this is 73.43, this is good, and from this one to this one are 30 millimeters. This is perfect. Now we'll go to features, use extruded boss base, and we'll select here reverse direction. We'll select here up to surface, and we'll select this surface. Press OK, and now we'll have to cut the inner side, this part. So for this we'll select this face, we'll open sketch, normal tool, and we'll select convert entities command, and from here we'll go here and we'll select sketch 4. Press OK, and we only need this part of the sketch. So with trim entities we'll cut the rest of it, and we'll only use that one. Now go to features, use extruded cut, select here tool and press OK. Now we have this hole which is looking good. Now select this face again, open another sketch. Actually we could have done this from the first, this sketch, but I forgot about it. Anyway, now let's make here two small rectangles, just like this one, and one on this other side. Now select these two, select here make equal, select these two, select here make equal, and this is good. Now let's dimension this. So this one will have 5 millimeters, okay, and this one will have 40, and from this line to this edge will be 40 millimeters, and select this line and this line, and select here make collinear. Good. Now go to features, use extruded boss base command, select here up to surface and select this face. Press OK, and this is almost done. We still have to do one hole here and two here. So to do this we'll open a sketch on this face, I think. Yes, select this face, open a sketch, normal tool. And here we'll have to make a circle like this, and select this point and this center point, select here make vertical, and select then this point and this one, and select make horizontal. Now this will have the diameter of 14 millimeters. Okay, oh, sorry. And now we'll have to make two circles here. So one and two, make them equal, select these two center line center points and this one, select here make vertical, and now let's give here the dimension of 14 millimeters in diameter. Between them will be 30 millimeters, and from this one to this edge will be 15. Now these two are fully defined, and the other one. Now let's go to features, use extruded cut and select here true. Okay, this seems good. So press OK now. Yeah. If this is happening, actually this is happening, we'll have to go back to cut extruded, select here edit feature, and here we select through all bolt and press OK. This happened because this side is bigger than this one. I mean, from the center till here is a bigger distance than from the center until here. So the sketch was inside. Okay. Now this part is done, and this is the end of this video. And in the next video, I'm gonna show you how to make the rest of these parts for this plow, and I'm gonna assemble it. Thank you for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video, where I'm gonna finish this small and interesting project, for me at least. And if you did like it, please leave a like, share, subscribe, and thank you. And do not forget to save this one too. I'm gonna save it on my desktop with the name of Central Axis.